Okay, so let's say I give you a glass of water, and then I give you red dye, and I give you green dye. And then I bet you that you can't put both the red dye and the green dye into that glass without the colors mixing. And then you say, Jarrett, why would I ever want to do that? And then I say, but I bet you can't. And you think about it, and you know that you can't just put the red dye and the green dye in because then they'll mix and you'll get some third color. But you're very clever. So you take the red dye, you put that into the water, it turns red. But then you take the green dye and you add that to oil. Then you take that oil and you drop it in the water. And now what you have are green oil droplets inside of red water. And now the colors stay separate. And that means that now you win. So our cells face a very similar problem. And that's because we're all complex organisms. And that means we have all these different kinds of cells. Neurons, muscle cells, skin cells, eggs, sperm. But to get all those different kinds of cells, that means some of our cells have to be able to split into two different kinds of cells. A cell type A that will go on to turn into one set of cells, and a cell type B that will go on to turn into some different set of cells. And what that means is that before that cell divides, it has to be able to separate all of its A-type stuff to one side and keep all of its B-type stuff on the other side, and it has to stop them from mixing. Now, the way the cell does this is actually very similar to our strategy with the oil and water. The problem for the cell, though, is that it has to go from these things already being mixed to them being separate, which means that some of the things in the cell have to change from being like water to being like oil. So how do you change something that was like water into something that's like oil? What I've discovered is that there's a special protein called MEG3, and the MEG3 is special because it can change from being like water to being like oil. And that means that now the cell can separate one set of components to one side and keep the other set of components on the other side, and it can stop them from mixing. What that means is that MEG3 is one answer to this very basic but a long-standing question in biology, because this process of the cell dividing asymmetrically is fundamental to all of complex life. Because when you lose this, you can't have any of those different cell types. You can't have neurons, you can't have skin cells, you can't have eggs, you can't have sperm. All of those are gone. Without this, most organisms are never even born. Without this, a lot of cells are prone to all these different forms of cancer, because when you lose this, what you're left with is the same kind of cell dividing into the same kind of cell over and over and over again. Thank you.